Hey, we're back here at the Ultimate House. The Geo Loop's been put in. We're going to take a look at it here. This is Mike and Teresa's home. Grayson Home Builders built it for them, okay? The place was kind of tight, so we did a unique loop design, a chicken foot loop. We got 1¼ inch line coming in, 1¼ inch line going back. I tell you something, when you're doing a Geo Loop, you got one shot to get it right. You mess this up, you got problems. And I'm always having people that don't know about Geo come to me and go, Dean, how does this work? Well, I'm gonna show you how it works. We've got some 1-inch pipe here. This is Geo pipe. It's good for 200 pounds of pressure, okay? So it takes a lot to destroy this pipe. But how this basically works is this is a supply pipe and this is a return pipe going back to the manifold. Water pumps through this pipe, goes to the end of the loop, comes back, goes back to the Geo unit. Now, it works through conductivity. So this water is going to take the same temperature as the ground. So right now, I measured the temperature a while ago, 60 to 58 degrees in here, about 6 foot down. This ground is nice and cold, it's nice and damp, so it's going to make a great conductor. In the air conditioned mode, this 60 degree water is going to go back to my condenser, and it's going to be able to get that heat off of that unit very efficiently. All right, we're going to talk about what not to do. This is why it's bad to short your loop. This pipe right here transfers water through it, as we went through before, and it extracts the heat out of the ground, okay? Now, if this pipe gets too hot because you don't have enough loop, enough transfer, what happens is the dirt around the pipe is called bait, and it will basically get hot, freeze up around it, and it will expand off the pipe ever so lightly. You won't get your transfer. But if you oversize your loop and you've got plenty of loop and we're putting in a soaker hose, Tim and Teresa will never have a problem in their loop. Let's talk briefly about the soaker hose. Now basically what we're going to do is we're going to cover about 2 foot of dirt over this trench right here. I'm going to take some Schedule 80 pipe and it goes right up under the house, and all they have to do is hook a water hose to it. If they ever had a problem with the loop getting hot, which they won't, but if they ever did, it's just a matter of hooking up the water, letting the water soak into this loop, and the water will get to the pipe, which it will stop the baking, bond the pipe, and it'll go back to working just like it always did. But if you oversize your loop, you don't have to worry about it. But just in case it ever did happen, it's a matter of flipping a switch and putting some water in the loop.